It's Wolfie John, and I'm back with another Movie Monday. Movies? Movie Monday. Movies. Now, this movie is based off a game, like, the game genre, and I don't know if they actually made manga or anything to this. But I actually didn't mind the movie so much. It gave more of the kind of backstory to one of the characters in the games that you kind of... He kind of gives you the information kind of over the shoulder kind of thing, which is cool, but trying to piece together his whole story sucks a little bit. So, the movie is Mass Effect, Paragon Lost. I believe you call it Paragon? Oh man, I have a hard time with Paragon and Renegade. I'm more of a Paragon person. So, if I'm ever running it, I'm usually like, what saves more people? I can't be bad. I can't be evil to that sense. Like, you get to know most of these people and all this stuff. This one is basically kind of before Mass Effect 3, and it follows James Vega and his story about his team and what happened just as the Reaper started attacking. Because he kind of, a Reaper kind of starts popping up. The anime style in and of itself for this is kind of... Like, you know when you see Corian, Arturian, or even the Asari, that they kind of have a certain look at them. Especially, I'm thinking of what Rex is, and my brain hurts. But Rex's people. Oh my goodness, it won't really tell me what race they are. Oh, the Novas too. But Rex's people are portrayed really weird in the anime. Like, they don't look right. Anime has its certain type. Like, the people in this is amazing. Asari. But most of the aliens are kind of looking funny in this. I will admit that. Until you get to kind of more robotic looking ones, and then the Geth, they look pretty good. So, but this follows Vega, and basically, kind of what happens to his team when one of the Reapers comes. And so they basically, you know, in the whole thing of this movie, is they do take down the Reaper, but he loses a lot of his team, and that's what Mass Effect 3 shows, is that he didn't feel like he was a good enough leader. He basically killed off a lot of these people. And it's not by choice, it's almost by force that he was like, I can't let you survive. So it's really sad for Vega. But it's a really, really interesting movie. And if you want more of a story behind who Vega is, this is a good one. I almost wish that they'd done maybe a 3D animation for this. Because, I mean, Mass Effect 3. You get to see Vega and stuff in basically a 3D zone. You see the character as if it was alive and stuff like that. They do kind of make Vega more proportionate, though. Like, not super muscular, but it's a really good one. And if you like Mass Effect, this isn't too bad. Just the anime sells. But the story itself is on par. It is really good, and I really like this one. And like I said, the story itself is amazing. Animation, meh. But I would recommend this for any Mass Effect fans at all. This is a good one. So, if you like this, definitely leave a like. Leave it in the comment section below. Have you seen this movie? Do you like it? Are you a Mass Effect fan? And I guess if we're going to do that, who's your favorite character in either all of Mass Effect or anything? Mine's Garrus. Can't help it. That Turian. And definitely subscribe, because I do make videos every day from either Sunday to Saturday or Monday to Sunday, whatever your schedule is. And I bring in either different types of anime, different types of manga, or the anime and manga you may know. And if you want to follow me on Twitter or Facebook, the links are down below. I hope that you've been having a wonderful day. I know I'm kind of... You won't know this, but I've been kind of uploading or making my videos a little bit later in the day, so I'm always trying to get the sun. Wolfie Chan out.